Hey gang, Meliclero here. So in this video, I just want to give you the penny tour inside my new online course called Digital Know-How. And it's designed for one thing, and that is to help you learn how to screencast using my techniques to help digitize your knowledge, get it online and web ready. Okay, so just so you know what you're getting in the course, you can actually access Digital Know-How from either your desktop computer, whether it's a Macintosh or a PC, or you can also use your iPad, your mobile device, like an iPad, and other mobile devices as well that will read MP4 video files. But when you first log in, you're going to be taken right to this dashboard area. Let's go ahead and go vertical, horizontal here. Across the top, you have all your different modules. So module 2 is all about Camtasia for Macintosh, and we will also be adding Camtasia Studio, which is your PC version for those of you who are on a Windows platform, and that basically comprises your fundamentals course. So you can actually tap in at a module level, and so when you tap in at the module level, you'll be able to get a listing of all of the subtopics that go underneath that. So for instance, in module 2, we go from recording your first project in Camtasia for Macintosh all the way down to publishing it out to the web so that you can share it with your audience and also your learners. Whoops. Go back into it here. And then across on the left side for all of these, you'll always be able to get to quickly go to another topic within that module because you'll have the menu on the left side. So that way you can be inside a video. So let's say this one here for how to finesse blemishes with transitions, right? So we go into there. So you could be down at a topic level watching a training video. And then at any point in time, you can quickly jump, use the left menu bar to be able to jump to your next topic within that module. And then of course, if you want, you're ready to go to the next module, you can then tap the module menu at the top. But then when you start getting to module 3, that's when we start getting to advanced and special topics. Module 3, for instance, addresses one of the key questions that I get asked a lot, which is, what is my production workflow? How do I get my videos scripted, recorded the audio, and then synchronize that with the video, and then maybe and then get that all published out to the web? So what is my workflow for that? So I address some of those things. And then as part of that, we talk about the scripting template and how audio impacts your video quality and so forth. So that's all about in production workflow. And then it's special topics, module 4. We address some of the other, you know, presentation formats that you might see out in the wild. So we'll talk about not just screencasting or web video and so forth, but some of the other ways you might want to engage some of your learners. So we'll talk about that. Like there might be mind maps. There's also like an iPad type of a presentation like what we're doing here. But we'll give you some examples of how some other folks have used some very compelling presentations online to engage their learners over the internet. And you'll be able to do the same thing as well. So that covers module 4. And so you can see module 4, if you look at the left-hand side here, module 4 covers some of these alternate format examples that you might want to consider when you're creating your own projects. But then we get into the big question that I get asked a lot, which is, how do I create this picture-in-picture effect? Because it is one of the kind of advanced techniques that helps you really engage your learners. So that way they're not just looking at a screencast presentation or a PowerPoint presentation online with a disembodied voice trying to walk them through a learning topic or whatever. And it really kind of helps to have an instructor kind of sitting side by side with them that they can look at as they're going through the topic. And so that's going to, I think, make a unique differentiator for you when you start creating your own learning topics. Okay, all right, so that's where the library stands today. And again, that's over 7 hours today of training library. So don't try to hit it all in one sitting, but definitely take your iPad with you or take your mobile device or your laptop and take some of these sessions in over at a local coffee house or something like that. Definitely still be doing some learning there. Now, I will say that training videos is not the learning style that everybody is comfortable with. The fact is, some people will, in fact, just need to be in a classroom type of an environment. So keep that in mind and just be cognizant of how your own learning style works. But if training videos and being able to have 24/7 access anytime, anywhere is something that you want to be able to that is a learning style that's conducive for you, then go ahead and hit the button below. Take a look at the topics, at the list of topics that are down there, and then go ahead and hit the button below, and then I'll see you inside the course.